Malco. I'm number 20. I'm a junior, and I'm a guard.
Alexa Holland, junior guard, number 10.
Ali Larkin, junior guard, number 30.
Bailey Abbott, senior forward, number 24.
Hi, I'm Keaton Stasia. I'm a junior, and I'm a forward, number 12.
Grace Pfeiffer, freshman guard, number 14.
Alexis Elliott, freshman guard, number 22.
Kennedy Moseman, freshman center, 44.
Morgan Ruff, freshman guard, number 32.
I'm Alexa Garrison, number 40, and a sophomore forward.
Emma Dahlquist, freshman center, number 54.
David Musselman, the Rochester Lady Zebras will go right to left. LaVille left to right. It'll be Tuttle and Abbott to jump center. Again, varsity only here tonight at LaVille. 6:30 start. Ball is up and the tip controlled by LaVille. Ace in the backcourt. She'll work against Holland. Rochester will slide back in that 1-3-1 zone that they've really adapted really well through the last couple of years. Out of Vernon. Vernon dribbles to the left wing. Now top of the key to Ace, who runs the point, stands in the center circle. Ace drives it right, so behind the arc, three-point line. Down the corner, her pass knocked away and stolen by Malco. Becky Malco, left side of the floor, stops, pop, high off the glass, no good. Rebound by Holland. Holland in the corner, dribbles to the wing. Now up top, reset for Rochester, gives down low to Stasiak. Back to Holland.
LaVille coming out, putting pressure on the basketball. They're not going to allow any open threes if they can help it.
There's a three for Holland. Shots off the mark, no good. Rebound fought for, and Tuttle comes out of it with it. And now Ace will cross the timeline with the basketball for the Lady Lancers. 50 seconds gone here in the opening quarter, no score. Ace drives to her left, gives the elbow to Tuttle. Looks back door, pass knocked away and stolen by Stasiak. Now gives the head to Larkin, now head to Holland. Holland play up off the window is good, and Rochester strikes first at 2-0. Each time down the floor so far, Rochester stepped in that passing lane and got an easy turnover.
Yeah, that's something they've done really well this year is create those turnovers.
And going to the basket hard. Is our leading scorer lead, and she goes in for a right-handed layup as LaVille breaks the press easily, and now we're tied at two. So Rochester will, for the first time tonight, have the ball in the half-court setting, and as Malco drives the basket, Ace is going to pick up the foul at the top of the three-point line, at that top of the key at the three-point line. And so it'll be out of bounds to Rochester on the far side of the floor on the sideline. 6.5 to play first quarter. We're tied at 2 here at LaVille. It'll be Rochester basketball going to our left. Stasiak will look to trigger it in. Keaton bounce pass into Malco. Malco drives it to the elbow right. Cut off by the double of the defense. Hesitates. Now kicks it outside to Holland. She drives it left inside the arc in the lane. She throws up a shot. And we're going to have a shot on the or a foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Is it a man-to-man or is it a zone? I think it's a zone. Yeah, it kind of does look like a zone. That foul's on Tiger, her first, team second. With pressure on the basketball, though, I mean, even though the rest of them are in the zone, there is pressure on the basketball.
So X hits the first free throw. She'll have one more for the Lady Zebras. 3-2 now, Rochester. One more coming from the junior. Isaac flies it. Good. And I think Coach Stasiak will want to turn up the pressure as Rochester's going to pick up LaVille three-quarter court. Vernon over the top of the defense to lead. Lead gets it down to Tuttle. Tuttle's wraparound pass is intended for Zeiger. And on the pass, we're going to have a foul in Rochester. It'll be out of bounds to LaVille. Baseline right with 6:13 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 4-2.
Foul go against Keaton, her first team first.
Vernon will look to get it in. Vernon looks over the top of the defense to Aish. Ace behind the arc, right side, now just inside the three-point line, and we're going to have a kicking violation against Rochester, and it'll stay with LaVille out of bounds underneath their own basket. Vernon will look to trigger it in again. Vernon gets it into Ace behind the arc, in the lane now, leaner, and she travels before the shot. It'll go back to Rochester.
That's their third turnover of the ball game already.
That's one of those things that she should have probably just come to a jump stop and either rised up or
dumped off the lead in the
right
corner.
Yeah. 4-2 Rochester. Malco backs away into the free throw line, now spins her way inside the lane. And that pass is taken away by LaVille, so Rochester will keep it down low, thankfully, because LaVille was going the other way with not very many Lady Zebras in front of them. X will look to trigger it in, baseline left, under 6 to play, first quarter, Rochester up 4-2. Holland in the left corner, back to Larkin, down low to Bailey Abbott. Her left-handed shot is no good, and the rebound for LaVille. Zeiger gives off to Aish. The Lady Lancers across the timeline through the center circle, works high on the left side of Vernon. Vernon holds back to Aish between the rings. Aish back to Vernon against Rochester's 1-3-1 zone, and here comes a run and jump defense. Aish just inside the arc. Jumper over Bailey Abbott. High arcing shot, no good. Malco with the board and run. Becky Malco, right side of the floor. She'll go coast to coast. She rises up, puts a shot up, short, no good. And the rebound is Zeiger, who gives off to Age. And now we're going to have a LaVille timeout. 5:20 to play in the first quarter. Rochester at 4-2. It is a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 30-second
timeout. Chuckling has returned for another season at LaVille. You can purchase one duck for $1, six ducks for $5. We also have pink ducks that are available for $2 each at halftime of tonight's varsity game. We're placing a bullseye in the middle of the floor, and you have an opportunity to win. Ducks are being sold at the West End of the gym.
.20 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 4-2. And the one thing LaVille has not let Rochester do is have a couple, two or three opportunities on the offensive end.
You're right. That's true. That's its zone and,
yep,
and their length. The other thing LaVille does really good is set up that half-court offense, and they're really patient. They're really patient in running their half-court offense, and we haven't really seen anybody else do that yet against,
yeah,
Rochester. It just feels as though they've slowed the pace of the game down.
Rochester out of that timeout, came out of half-court trap and forced a turnover, so that's a turnover again on LaVille. The Stasiak pass a dumb down low to Bailey Abbott, outside to Holland for three, left corner, no good. Rebound fought for, and we're going to have a foul over the back on Bailey Abbott, and it'll be back to LaVille. Like I said before, LaVille doing a great job forcing Rochester to just one and done, doing a great job on the blocking out. Now they just need to put the points on the board here. Rochester up 4-2. The half-court trap. Lead has it in the left corner. Now dribbles to the top of the key. Gives to Vernon. Vernon's pass to Tuttle in the corner. Tuttle gets a double team. Back to Vernon quickly to Ace. Ace drives it left. 15 feet away from the basket. Come off with a double team outside to Vernon. And then her pass almost stalled, but got back to Lead. Lead gives to Ace. She'll fire a three from the left corner. It's good. And LaVille is up 5-4. Quickly hit the floor of the Lady Zebras. Again, going to our left. Malco at the volleyball line. Stasiak at the volleyball, or the free throw line. Gives it down to Bailey Abbott. Abbott shots missed. Stasiak shots missed. And Abbott then is fouled underneath the basket as Rochester missed three shots at point blank.
Yeah, Abbott had a very good look at the basket. And just the ball just rolled off the back of the rim to the other side. Stasiak did a good job of getting in for the rebound, but she wasn't able to do any better to put the ball off the glass.
Kennedy Musselman and Morgan Ruff into the game. Bailey Abbott and King Stasiak out. Nina Zadak into the game for LaVille. Holland outside left, drives the baseline, throws up a shot. It's good, and Rochester back up 6-4. Great move by Alexa Holland. And here comes a half-court trap again by the Zebra defense. Vernon to Aish, crossed the timeline finally, works in the middle of the floor, kicks it into the backcourt, and we're going to have a kick on Becky Malco. And it will stay with LaVille right here in front of the scorer's table at midcourt. 6-5 Rochester, 3:56 to play in the first quarter. Vernon will look to get it in. Does so to Lead. Lead between the rings. Top of the key, works the left side, backs away inside the three-point line. Now outside to Vernon. Vernon holds the ball above her head, the volleyball line. Now works right side to Lead, still behind the arc. Lead, one dribble, drives it left to Zeiger. Zeiger against Musselman. One dribble, kicks it out to Lead. Lead drives in the paint, goes to the basket, right-handed layup is good. Yikes, that was easy. Lead back, and LaVille back up 7-6 with 3:25 to play in the first quarter. Malco out to Ruff, now to Holland. Three, wide open left wing, no good, too hard. Rebound fall for, Lead comes out of there with it, runs for LaVille. Lead loses the handle, picks it up, gives to Zeiger. Now quickly near side to Sadak. Got an ace for three. It's good. And it's 9-6. LaVille on top by three. Malco in the paint. Out to Holland. X drives in the paint. Outside to Larkin. She'll fire a three. No good. Rebound fall four. LaVille loses it. And Holland has it. Now to Larkin. Back to Holland, left side. DeLarkin behind the arc, left wing. She'll fire another three. It's in and out, no good. Rebound, fall for LaVille, and Lead comes out of there with it. Lead will jog it up the floor through the center circle. Top of the key. Stops, takes it outside to Vernon. Vernon on the wing. Drives it in the paint. Goes to the basket. She's going to be fouled before the shot. and it'll be out of bounds to Rochester. I'm sorry, to LaVille baseline right. 9-6 LaVille, 2.5 to play in the first quarter.
So I'm guessing that last shot by Esch was a two-pointer instead of a three.
Vernon looks to get it in. Does go to Zeiger, and then Musselman's going to pick up a foul for reaching in. And she won't stay in there long. She'll come out after she's blown down two defensive assignments. So Larkin and Musselman out. Bailey Abbott and Keaton Stasiak back in. Vernon will look to get it in. Baseline left. Gets it in. Stolen by Bailey Abbott. Now to Ruff. Morgan Ruff quickly up the floor, right side of the lane. She'll go to the basket hard. Throws up a shot, no good. And the rebound to Lead. Lead then gives off to Aish. And she'll jog it up for LaVille. 9-6 Lady Lancers here at LaVille High School. Lead on the wing, high on the right side. One dribble to Zadak. Back to Aish on the left side. In the corner to wide open Lead. 4-3. No good. Barely draws iron. Rebound fault four. Holland comes out of there with it. X runs. X left side of the floor. Hesitates. Pulls it back outside. Feeds down low to Bailey Abbott. Outside to Malco. Three, top of the key. Good, and we're tied at 9. Minute 45 to play in the first quarter. Here comes a half-court trap, three-quarter-court trap. And Vernon just chucks it out of bounds. That no-look pass will get you every time, especially unguarded,
especially when they're not looking for it.
Tuttle back in, and coming out of the game is Zeiger. We're tied at 9 in the minute 40 to play in the first quarter. Becky Malco will run the point for the Lady Zebras across the timeline against the 1-3-1 zone of LaVille. Malco drives it right, kicks it in the corner to Ruff. Ruff, Stasiak behind the arc on the left wing. She drives it, gets back to Ruff in the corner, drives the baseline, does Morgan. Skip past to Malco, and we're going to have a legal screen on Abbott. Is that right?
What they're calling.
That's going to be 3 on Bailey?
I got it for 2.
2? Okay. A minute 23 to play in the first quarter, a tie to 9. And now Coach Stasiak looking up and down his bench saying, where do we go to now? Lead. No look to Tunnel. Tunnel, her layup is good, except she travels. LaVille back up 11-9. Holland outside left, hesitates, accelerates. Free throw line out to Malco, fakes a shot. She drives it left. She will pull up jumpers, blocked by Lead. Lead against Holland. Lead pushes Holland away, gets the basketball back, puts up a shot, no good. And the rebound to Ruff, and now Ruff is going to be fouled by Aish. With 56 seconds to play in the first quarter, with LaVille leading 11-9.
And Aish will pick up her second. So right now, with Aish out of the game, that leaves only Lead as the biggest threat. But Lead's been doing everything offensively and offensively.
Ashton Brenner comes in for LaVille. She's a freshman. Stasiak has the left corner now on the wing to Malco. Under 45 seconds to play in the first quarter. Holland has it. Quickly to Ruff, wrap around pass to Stasiak. Layup is good. Helter Skelter turns into 2 for Rochester. We're tied at 11. 30 seconds to play, first quarter. Lead brings it up the floor. Gets it ahead to Tunnel. Tunnel over the top of the defense to Vernon. Out of Ashenbrenner. To a cutting Lead. Goes to the basket. Throws up a shot. It's good.
And the Lady Lancers do a great job of not only setting picks, but using those screens to find open passing lanes.
And then Ruff has her pass stolen by Lead. Lead leads ahead to Tunnel and throws it out of bounds. 8.5 to play in the first quarter. LaVille leading 13-11, and Rochester will have the basketball, hopefully for the final shot of the period. And now Morgan Ruff will bring the ball up, and Holland will look to get her spot to find a shot. Ruff with 6, crosses the timeline with 4, works to the left side with 3. Ruff goes to the basket, and she's going to be fouled on the way to the basket by LaVille, and it's going to be out of bounds to Rochester with 1.8 to play in the first quarter, down by 2. Zajac picks up the foul. Holland lobs it in the backcourt to Malco. She picks it up. Malco's going to have to chuck one at the buzzer. It's on the way, and it's no good. After 1, Rochester trails LaVille 13-11. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
Shepherd's made my buying process easy. The sales staff at Shepherd's was extremely knowledgeable and helped me find the right vehicle at a price that fit my budget. They had a great selection of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from, and they gave me a great deal on my trade-in. I wouldn't shop anywhere but Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester. They really are my local hometown dealer.
To the second quarter we go here at LaVille. The Lady Zebras will start with the basketball going to our left. LaVille leading right now after one, 13-11. Malco with the basketball against the zone defense by LaVille. Holland back to Malco. Malco drives it right. Cut off by the double team. Out to Stasiak near the volleyball line on the right side of the floor. Now pass to Malco between the rings. She'll reset for Rochester to Holland. Holland back to Malco high on the right side. Becky Holtz drives it around the defense. Got to get rid of it. Finally does to Ruff. Ruff over the top of defense to Malco. Quick three left wing. Short draws nothing but very little iron, I should say. And then Ruff with the rebound. Holland kicks it out to Malco. She drives it left at the free throw line. Wrap around pass to Bailey Abbott. Shot no good. Her putback is no good. She gets the rebound. The putback is no good. Gets the rebound again. Put back and she fouled.
Those are the shots you got to have. And Abbott had three chances and she couldn't get any of them the ball.
And each shot wedged almost between the backboard and the rim. They're all
quite
short.
Yeah.
She didn't quite get it high enough.
She's not getting enough legs into it. She's short on all of them.
Allie Larkin will come back in after the first free throw. Assuming it's not for Bailey Abbott, we'll see. Abbott, the left-handed shooter, fires the first one. No good off the side of the rim. She'll have one more. So Larkin back into the game, and Alexa Holland will come out. 7:16 to play first half. LaVille by two with 13-11. And Bailey Abbott, the lone senior for the Lady Zebras, on the line for one more. Bailey steps up to the line, dribbles twice, eyes it, flies it. No good. Short, and the rebound to Vernon. Vernon LaVille gives down a lead. Lead jogs up the floor for the Lady Lancers. Top of the key. Bounce pass to Vernon high on the right side. One dribble for Vernon. Gives him the corner to Tuttle. Tuttle, one dribble in the corner. Top of the key now to Sadak. Sadak in the corner to lead. Lead against the double team. Got to get rid of it. There's a 5 second. Where was that at? Four, yeah. Lead now back to Vernon. She'll fire a three left baseline. Good. And out the 5-point lead for LaVille at 16-11. And I got a feeling that we're going to go to that box and one very soon.
Yeah, we're probably going to have to. Coach Stasiak discussed a couple of the girls fighting that bronchitis. And it's starting to show here in the second quarter. The shots are coming up short from all over the floor.
Malco shot no good. Again, Rochester turned away, one and done. And Lee quickly up the floor. Lee top of the key, nobody in her face, fires a three. It's good as it rattles home. And now Coach Stasiak will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
3 second timeout.
Probably because she lives in South Carolina.
To play in the first half. LaVille leads Rochester 19-11 here at LaVille High School. Musselman back into the game. Bailey Abbott to come out. Brad Thomas on David Musselman. Malco through the center circle. Works to the right side. Crossover dribble out to Ruff. Ruff works to the free throw line. Out at Larkin to Musselman. Then Kennedy gets it to Ruff. Jump pass outside to Malco in the lane. Becky then pushes to Larkin. Larkin high on the left side with the basketball. In the lane to Stasiak. Wrap around pass to Ruff. Ruff goes to the basket. Throws up a shot. She fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. So Morgan Ruff, the freshman.
Coming against Zeiger, sorry. First second.
That's right. We'll go to the line to shoot two. Rochester down by 8 at 19-11. Here early in the second quarter as Ruff hits the first free throw. She'll have one more.
Lady Zebras just having a tough time finding open shots against that 2-3 zone from LaVille.
Second one no good, and the rebound to Lead. Lead gives the head to Vernon, and she'll cross the timeline for LaVille. Outside the Lead, middle of the floor now for the Lady Lancers to Tuttle. Tuttle stands high on the right side, wide open three. She'll let it go. It's no good, and the rebound fall for, and fortunately for Kennedy, Morgan Ruff right there to clean up her mess, but LaVille's going to keep possession. Boy, as well she's played, she played it against Caston. Not playing very well right now. 5.5 to play, and Becky Malco comes out of the game. Next comes back in.
Lead's been making a lot of people look bad tonight, that's for sure.
The freshman, Ashenburner. She misses the shot, and then the rebound goes to Vernon, and she travels. 5:28 to play, first half. 7-point lead for LaVille. And Holland will walk it up the floor for the Lady Zebras. And now Morgan Ruff will run the point. Ruff through the center circle. Works to the right wing. Jump pass to Stasiak. Team back to Ruff. Three in the way. Right wing. No good. Muscle to the rebound. The put back on the way for the freshman is no good. And Kennedy going to pick up foul number two for coming over the back. Five 11 to play in the first half. Rochester down by 7. Bailey Abbott comes back in and Muscle to come out. Lead runs the point. Picks up her dribble outside to Vernon. LaVille yet to cross the timeline. Lead one dribble back to Vernon. Quickly in the corner, Ashenbrenner. Her pass is picked off and stolen by Malco, or make that to Holland. X runs left side. X crossover dribble out to Ruff. Ruff one dribble, sends cross court to Larkin. Allie, a couple of dribbles out top of the key to Stasiak. She drives it right inside the 3-point line out to Allie Larkin, top to Ruff. Another three on the way for the freshman off the window and no good. And we're going to have a foul for over the back on Vernon, I think. And she came over Stasiak's back. And that should send Keaton to the line for one in the bonus, I think.
Well, that foul's against Vernon for second.
.442 to play in the first half. Rochester down by 7. And Stasiak at the line for one in the bonus for the Lady Zebras. First one is no good. And Tuttle with the rebound. Her pass almost stolen, and now X forces a turnover. Nice job by Holland. And Rochester going to get it back under the basket baseline left.
Well, not only are the Lady Zebras struggling from the field to find anything, but they're struggling now from the free throw line as well.
Holland baseline right. Looks triggered in, down by 7. 4:39 to play, first half. Holland gets it into Larkin. Back to Holland on the baseline. X back to Larkin on the wing. Allie a couple of dribbles. High on the left side to Ruff. She drives it right around the defense. Gives to Holland. Now to Larkin. Back to Holland behind the arc. Next in the lane. Outside to Stasiak. Keeps to Ruff on the left side. And then has her pass. Makes that ball taken away by the defense. And we're going to have a blocking foul on Holland. And that's going to send Lead to the line to shoot two.
Holland will pick up her first. Wow. Wasn't much Holland can do. Lead was going to get an easy layup. So she tried to slide in there, pick up the charge.
Well, you're talking about being out of sync.
Oh, yeah.
4:17 to play in the first half. Rochester by 7. And McKenzie Lee, the 5'7 senior at the line to shoot two. First on the way is up and good. Nothing but net.
Well, like I said, it's everything. It's, you know, we're not moving real well. We're slow, a step behind.
Yeah,
we're not able to get the shots. We're not even getting them up on the rim. They're coming up short, and the free throws are the same thing. So whatever bug they've had this week, it's showing up tonight.
Lead's second one is good again, and LaVille stretches their lead to 9. 21-12, LaVille with 4:15 to play in the first half. Malco is back into the game, kicks it out to Ruff. Morgan gets a pick from Stasiak, drives it left, now to Holland. Heck. Backs it out on the baseline, behind the arc, outside now to Ruff. Morgan drives it right at the free throw line, outside to Malco, swings it left side to Holland. X, three, left side, too hard. And now we're going to have a tie-up between LaVille and Ruff, and it's going to stay with Rochester. Tuttle will come back into the game.
Well, the Lady Lancers are doing a great job of not only packing the lane, but they're pulling out on the ball, so there are really no open threes. Yeah. Holland let that one fly with somebody in her face, and it was just way high.
Ruff passes to Bailey Abbott, kicks it out the mouth, go back to Becky, fakes the three, drives in the paint, pass down low to Stasiak. Her layup is good in traffic. And that's the first field goal Rochester's had in quite some time,
our first one this quarter.
Lead against Holland. Picks the way through traffic, gives the head to Vernon. Out of Ashton Burner. And her jumper from 10 feet is good.
And the Lady Lancers are just beating the Lady Zebras down the floor on that press.
I know Coach Stasiak's looking up and down that bench for an answer, and he can't find one right now. Ruff back to Malco. And her pass is tipped away, but Holland picks it up near the timeline before it goes into the backcourt. Gives it to Malco. Malco down low to Stasiak. Layup is no good. Rebound fall four. Still fighting for the foot with basketball, and LaVille comes out of it with it. The lead. Allie Larkin will come back in to the next dead ball. Lead crosses through the center circle for LaVille, who are up nine. The Tuttle travels, no call. Lead, spinner, jumper, no good. Put back by Stasiak is good. LaVille up now by 11, a 3:40 to play in the first half. Malcolm's looked it up before, between her legs, dribble, wrap around pass to Ruff. She drives the baseline, and she's going to be fouled by LaVille's Vernon. That's going to send Ruff to the line for one of the bonus. Vernon's third. Well, I guess if there's a silver lining, that's it.
Well, if we're not too far out of it.
25-14 Rochester. Aish. And Ruff hits the first one. Aish and also Tiger will come back into the game. Grace Pfeiffer will come into the game for the first time tonight for the Lady Zebras. And Pfeiffer will replace Bailey Abbott. So now you've got five shooters on the floor for the Lady Zebras. 2.5 to play, first half. Rochester's cut this lead to 10. And Ruff has one more to cut it to 9. Morgan ready. Eyes a second one. Free throw by the freshman is no good. And the rebound to Tuttle. Tuttle now gives off to Aish, and she'll bring it up the floor. Aish across the timeline right. Tuttle right in front of the Rochester bench. Dribbles around the defense. Outside to Zeiger. Zeiger backs away against Stasiak. Cut off by the defense. Now to Ashenbrenner. Ashenbrenner to Tuttle. Top to Ace. I just note lead still in the game. To Zeiger, and Zeiger is going to be fouled on the drive. It's going to center to the line to shoot free throws. 2:07 to play, first half. 25-15 LaVille.
Holland will pick up her second foul.
Larkin back in, and Morgan Ruff will come out. Bailey Abbott will come back in. And Abbott will replace Alexa Holland for the Lady Zebras. 11-point lead has been the biggest lead of the night for LaVille, and they have an opportunity here to stretch it to 12 with one of the bonus. Tigers' free throw is good. She'll have one more. 26-15 LaVille. One more coming for Zeiger, a 5'10 junior for the Lady Lancers. LaVille, two dribbles. Eyes a second one. It's on the way and no good. Rebound to Abbott. He clears the Stasiak and Keaton will run the point. Keaton crosses right through the center circle. Works right, crosses over, goes left. Now to Pfeiffer. Stops the key to Malco. Becky against Lead in the defense. Trips on the floor. And LaVille takes the basketball away from Malco, gives the lead. 3-1 break for LaVille. Aishan Brenner, her layup is no good. Rebound tipped around and goes out of bounds. Last touch by Rochester. LaVille basketball on the far side of the minute 42 to play in the first half. LaVille up by 11. Aishan Brenner to Zeiger. Outside the lead of the volleyball line. Lead one, a couple of dribbles. Almost has her ball taken away from her. Now gives to Aish. 2-3 zone by the Lady Zebras. Now in the half court to trap defense. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Rochester. It'll stay with LaVille right at the timeline. Going to our right. The minute 25 to play in the first half.
LaVille going to be content to try and run the clock out of the half.
Why not?
Yep. They'll look for an easy one. If they get one, I'm sure they'll take it.
Lead high on the right side to Aish. Back to Lead. Has the ball tipped out of bounds by Malco. It'll stay right in front of the Rochester bench. Well, they run 10 seconds off at a time. If Rochester keeps doing that, they'll milk the clock away. You're right. Hayes, top to lead. She stands between the rings, directs traffic. Now left side to Ashenbrenner. Ashenbrenner over the top of the defense to Ace. Ace drives, cut off of the defense, out the lead. Good lead to Ashenbrenner. Ashenbrenner's free throw is no good. The jumper is no good. And we're going to have a push off on Zeiger or Tuttle.
Tuttle, I believe.
Well,
they're going to call that on Zeiger, her third.
Well, now LaVille's in a little bit of foul situation.
Zeiger and Furman, two starters with three fouls apiece.
So Bailey Abbott at the line to shoot two for Rochester with 60 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester down by 11. Bailey Abbott's first one on the way. Lefty's free throw is off the back of the rim. No good. She'll have one more. Coming back into the game is Haley Cox, the 5'11 freshman, and coming out of Zeiger. So Zeiger and Vernon on the bench, both with three personal fouls.
All right. Lady Zebras, 2 of 8 in this quarter from the line. And one field goal.
Yeah. Bailey Abbott's second one on the way is no good again. Rebound to lead. 26-15, and now we're going to have a foul on Keaton Stasiak, who just picked up foul number two,
yep.
And we're going to walk to the other end and shoot one in the bonus.
So Holland, Stasiak, and Abbott all with two for the starters of Rochester.
Boy, he's going to have to find an answer in the locker room. Lexi Elliott will come into the game for the first time for Rochester. X will come back in as well with two fouls. Keaton Stasiak comes back out. Ruff will come back in. Bailey Abbott comes out, and Grace Piper will come out. 56.7 to play in the first half. LaVille by 11 at 26-15. Aaron Ace at the line to shoot. One of the bonus, first one on the way, is good. Fairly moves the net. She'll have one more. Just a freshman. She handled herself better than a freshman. One more coming for Ace. 5-3 freshman for the Lady Lancers. Looking to push this lead to 13. Eyes the second one. No good. And the ball tipped around, and Ruff comes out of it with it. Gives to Holland. Rochester runs to our left. Down by 12. Holland behind the arc. On the wing. Gives to Malco. 3 on the baseline. It's good. Finally. 27-18. 40 seconds to play in the first half. Ace runs for LaVille across the timeline left. Goes all the way to the wing. Goes all the way to the basket. Cut off by the defense. And can take the basketball. Oh, called jump. Larkin and Ace is going to be called for a tie-up. Just as Rochester's going the other way of the basketball, they call a late jump ball. With 31.6 to play in the first half, Coach Stasiak not happy with that call. Can't blame him. Bounce pass comes in to LaVille, and Cox can't handle it. It's going to go back to Rochester with 28 seconds to play. In the first half, with 27-18 lead, LaVille, Musselman back into the game. Going to have to play a whole lot smarter than what she played the first couple of times in the basketball game because that was pathetic. Ruff comes out. Lexi Elliott comes out and Stasiak back in.
They also just got to survive 28 seconds.
Yeah. Yeah. If only. 20 seconds. Malco stands in the center circle with 19. Drives it left to Holland with 18. Back to Malco behind the left side of the 15. Crossover dribble in the lane. Wrap around past the Musselman. We're going to have a foul coming against LaVille. And that's going to send Malco to the line to shoot two with 13.3 to play in the first half. Rochester down 27-18.
Foul coming against Cox, her first.
And so Malco at the line to shoot two. Grace Piper and Morgan Ruff will come back in after the first free throw.
Malco with a couple of three-pointers, one in each quarter.
Malco's first one is good. Back into the game. Those two, X and Stasiak, with two fouls coming out. Boy, Rochester with an opportunity here to cut this to 7. And it could have been easily 22 at one point.
You're right.
Well, yeah?
Yeah.
It could have been ugly. Malco's second on the way. Good again. 27-20. LaVille by 7 with 10.
The last 5 points by Malco.
Quickly up the court is Ace with 7. Ace outside the lead with 3. The 3 on the way is no good. Rebound fall for Tuttle comes out of there. Jumper, the buzzer's good. At halftime, LaVille leads 29-20. You're listening to Ladies' Year Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966. Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it is brand new, and he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
The original five, Larkin, Malco, Stasiak, Holland, and Abbott on the floor for the Lady Zebras. Malco drives the baseline, throws up a 10-footer, it rolls in. Rochester scores the first 2 points of the half and cuts the lead to 7. Nate with the basketball. Over the top of the defense to lead, and she has a stolen by Larkin. Larkin right side of the floor. Stops in the lane to Stasiak. Layup is on the way, it's good! And Rochester cuts the lead to 5. 30 seconds gone in the third quarter.
See a little more focus, don't you?
Yeah, I see somebody lit a fire into somebody's locker room, but they needed it. Tuttle drives the baseline, cut off by Stasiak, outside to Vernon. Vernon down low to Zeiger. Zeigerson has it ripped away by from Larkin. Larkin has the basketball now. McCullough not happy. He kicks the chair. Malco drives it right, and then we're going to have a foul going to the basket against LaVille. I'm not sure I saw that. Had to be a hand check. That's on lead. Her first. 7:04 to play in the third. Rochester's got the LaVille lead down to 5 at 29-24. Malco top the key.
Remember, Zeiger and Burnham with 3 fouls for the Lady Lane.
Exactly. Wrap around pass to Malco. 3 right wing. No good. And 1 and done again for Rochester. Tuttle grabs the board. Now to Hayes. LaVille pushes it up the floor. Hayes to the center circle. Over the top of the defense to Tuttle. Tuttle over the top of the defense. And right in front of the bench. Lee sees him going out of bounds. In the corner to Ace in the baseline. Against the double team. Got to get rid of it. Does shoot. Lead. Lee's wraparound layup is short. And the rebound is Stasiak. King gets to Larkin. Rochester runs down by 5. Larkin bounce pass top to Holland. X picks up her dribble and out of Malco where on left side. Malco drives the left on the baseline. Come up with the defense. Gets to have it. Now to Stasiak. Keaton throws up a shot in the lane. It's off the glass and good. 29-26. Rochester's cut into this lead.
Stasiak matched her first half total in just the first two
good
minutes
for her.
Of the third quarter.
Somebody need to pick him up.
Yeah.
Tuttle sees him going out of bounds and then travels. Rochester's going to get it back. Will LaVille use a timeout?
That's 3 turnovers on LaVille in the first 2 minutes of this third quarter.
Under 6 to play in the third quarter. Rochester has it down to 1 possession. LaVille leads 29-26. And Malco will bring it up the floor.
6-0 lead for Rochester to start the second half.
Malco drives it right in the lane. Kicks it out to Larkin at the volleyball line. Bounce pass to Malco. Drives it right. Stop. Down low to Bailey Abbott. Ball's loose on the floor. Ball still loose. Stasiak comes flying in after. We're going to have a tie-up, and LaVille's going to get it back. 5:40 to play in the third quarter. LaVille by 3. And the Lancers going to our left. Ace will bring it up the floor. Right in front of the Rochester bench. Picks up a dribble, gives to Vernon. Vernon now drives it right across the timeline. Bounce pass in the corner. Is not going to bounce by Stasiak. It'll stay at the timeline to LaVille on the far side. Vernon will look to get it in. Slaps the basketball, looking to get it in. Still looking. Does the tunnel on the left wing. Tunnel just inside the arc. Gives the lead. Now back to Vernon. She drives it left against Stasiak. Cut off at the baseline. Top to H. 3 on the way. Top to keep for LaVille. It's good. And that's a 2. I beg your pardon, right? That's a 2. 31-26 LaVille. Quickly, Rochester the other way. Holland in the lane. Kicks it out to Malco. She'll fire a 3. Top to key. It's good.
Malco with her 3rd 3-pointer tonight.
And Rochester cuts the lead to 2. H. Over the top of defense. Pass knocked out of bounds by Malco. Looking for a lead. Coach Stasiak reaches to the girls on the bench, and now LaVille will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Ladies for Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Quarter. LaVille up by two. Hayes the basketball. Gives him the corner to Seiger. Seiger goes to the basket hard. She goes up a right-handed shot. Goes in. Rochester quickly up the floor. Down by four. Malco to Holland. Heck, back to Malco on the right wing. Becky drives in the paint and is fouled away there by Lead. And that'll be foul number two on Lead.
Picked up two fouls here in the third quarter pretty quickly.
Gotta wonder if she's getting tired.
Yeah. Yeah, kind of act like it. Malco had a step on her each time there. She drove down the top of the lane, Lead on her hip.
Holland, no look pass into Larkin in the corner. Back to Holland on the baseline. Next against Lead. Picks up a dribble. Gives to Holland or makes that Larkin right in front of the Rochester bench. Over the top of the defense to Malco. Becky drives it right. Cut off. Gives to Stasiak. Back to Malco. Three on the way for the Lady Zebras. It's short. And the rebound to Zeiger. We're going to have a foul on Rochester. And that's either going to be Larkin or Stasiak.
Stasiak going to pick up the foul. That's her third.
4:21 to play in the third quarter. Rochester down by four. LaVille will have it back, and Morgan Ruff will come back into the game, and Keith will come out. Brad Thomas on David Musselman.
Well, as the Zebras start to go to the bench, we'll see if they can keep the intensity.
Yeah. Rochester had this one as close as two in this half. They were down by 12 at one point. Vernon behind the arc, left side, drives around Bailey Abbott, beats down Little Zeiger, she travels. Rochester going to get it back after another turnover on LaVille, down by four.
Man, for 11 turnovers in the first half, they've got four here in the third.
Really, okay. Larkin on the wing, back to Malco, top of the key, swings to X, wide open three, left wing, short, rebound to Ruff, put back, no good, a lot of contact, no foul, and then LaVille, what? LaVille knocked it out of bounds. They're going to keep possession.
Wow.
4 minutes to play, third quarter. LaVille, 4-point lead and travels, no call. Lead across the timeline, middle of the floor, outside to Ace. Ace then has it stolen by Ruff to Holland. X to the left side of the floor, picking away through traffic. X goes coast to coast, throws him a shot, it's good.
Holland's first point since the first quarter.
Lead back down to two. Lead then travels, and it's going to go back to Rochester. Down by two, 3:29 to play in the third.
I don't think she traveled. I didn't see it on that possession, no. The makeup from the possession before.
Very well could be. Holland drives it right, makes that Malcolm drives it right. And her pass tipped away. And stolen. LaVille has it, been stolen back by Malco, and then we're going to have a foul on the entry pass on LaVille. Bailey Abbott misses another point-blank shot.
Well, that foul goes against Tuttle, her first.
Holland will look to trigger it in, baseline right. 3:19 to play in the third, Rochester down by two. Bailey Abbott at the elbow, dribbles the top of the key, and her wraparound pass is kicked away by Vernon. Again, this is as close as Rochester's been in a long time.
Since the early stages of the first quarter.
Yeah, you're right. 33-31. Bill by two. Malco gets the inbound pass from Larkin. Middle of the floor is Malco. Picks up her dribble, gets to Holland high on the left side. X goes left, stops, pops, throws up a shot. It is good. Bounces off the back of the rim. We're tied at 33. 3 minutes to play in the third. Takes the basketball. Quick up the court for LaVille.
It's been the Lady Zebras' defensive pressure that's got them back in the game.
And now we're going to have a carry on Lead, and it's going to get back to Rochester. Down by, I'm sorry, we're tied at 33. I can't remember the last time we led 2-0.
Maybe. I don't even know that we did that.
5-4, something like that.
Yeah.
2:45 to play in the third. We're tied at 33 here at LaVille High School. Rochester basketball going to our right. Market works to the right side, out to Malco. Malco picks up a bad pass, drives it left, and travels.
She's trying to create a passing lane for Abbott. Abbott didn't move down towards the baseline, and the Lady Lancers were able to slide easily into position and take away that passing avenue.
2:36 to play in the third quarter. We're tied at 33. H picks up her dribble, gives to Vernon. Vernon on the right side of the floor, back to H. Middle of the floor. LaVille still trying to cross the timeline, and Russ knocks it out of bounds. It'll stay with LaVille on the far side. Three-quarter court.
All right, you like to see the hustle.
Absolutely. I like her. Vernon looks to get it in. Vernon looks to get it in. No sort of stagger. Travels, no call. Just throws up a shot, no good. Malco with the rebound. Malco, right side of the floor, pushes up the floor, right wing, crossover dribble in the paint, goes to the basket, throws up a shot, no good, no contact, a lot of contact, no foul, and the rebound to LaVille. And LaVille, and Lee has her shot, or a ball picked away, stolen, and the ball is tipped around the bounds. You can see last touch by Rochester, and Coach Stasiak begging for a call, no call yet.
And Malco not able to make the shot, and no call on the contact.
2:02 to play in the third. Rochester and LaVille tied at 33.
So Stasiak, got to be careful.
So Ace gets the inbound pass from Lead. Gets it back to Lead. Lead, left side of the floor. He's getting bodied up by Malco. Drives it across the timeline. We're going to have a foul on Abby Malco. I'm sorry, Becky Malco. Load her up the floor just a little too long.
I think Malco's first. Team second.
Vernon will look to get it in right at the score table. Gets it in to Lead. To Zeiger. Off her shoulder, out of bounds. Rochester going to get it back. Minute 50 to play in the third. We're tied at 33.
Nine turnovers for the Lady Lancers in this quarter.
Which is why Rochester got into, back into this one.
Exactly. That's why the score's tied right now.
Minute 45 to play in the third quarter. Malco right through the center circle. Zone defense for LaVille. Malco. Out to Larkin, and Larkin's pass is kicked away by Lead. We'll see with Rochester right in front of their own bench.
Well, the Zebras really need to be conscious of where Lead is at.
Yeah,
they can't just lay one out there, you know, a lazy pass out back out front. They got to be sharp and they got to be crisp.
Holland roars to the right. Just a couple of picks down the lane. Down low to Abbott. Her layup is no good. Short again. And that's going to send Abbott to the line to shoot two after she fouled. With a minute 27 to play in the third, Rochester LaVille tied at 33.
So Ashley's going to pick up her third. That's the third starter for LaVille now with three. Abbott is 0 for 4 from the free throw line.
Bailey, left-handed free throw shooter. Dribbles a couple of times. Eyes the first one. It's on the way and in and out. No good. We'll have one more. One more coming for the senior, looking to break this 33 tie. Second on the way, looks better this time, it is good. 34-33, Rochester's first lead since early in the first quarter. Vernon, left side of the floor, back to Ace. Ace almost has a pocket pick, now gives fire to Vernon. Outside to wide open leads, her three on the way is no good. Catches the rebound and runs. Holland left side of the floor, now holds up. Hesitates, gives top to Ruff. Ruff dribbles around the defense, down the lane, goes to the basket, throws up a shot, it's good! Rochester up by four, a three. That's 36-33, it's 60 seconds to play in the third.
Ruff recognizing everybody on the middle team with foul trouble.
Yeah.
He just drove around them and put the ball off the glass.
Ace, the lead. Lead, 15 feet away from the basket to get the double team. Top to Ace, she'll fire a three straight away. No good, too hard. Rebound to Abbott. Abbott then loses it. Will picks it up. And Zeiger has it with 39. Out to Vernon. Vernon then is going to be called for a push-off charge. That's going to be four on Vernon with 35.7 to play in the third. Rochester up by three.
Lady Lancers scored 13 in the first, 16 in the second. They've only scored four in the third,
thankfully. So Ace and Vernon comes out. Stasiak. And Ashenbrenner back in for LaVille. 30 seconds to play in the third. Rochester up by three. Down by nine to start this seven.
Yeah, nine
to start this quarter. Malco bounce pass to Holland. Back to Malco with 20. Malco stands three steps inside the 10-second line with 18. Now dribbles, switches direction. Bounce pass to Holland with 12. Holland works to the right side with 10. Comes back outside, crossover dribble in the lane. Her floater in the paint is up last, no good with 6. Rebound to LaVille, and Larkin's going to pick up a foul with 5 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 36-33. And Allie Larkin just picked up a foul, so LaVille's going to have the last shot of the quarter. Larkin. Asher Brenner gets it in to Tuttle. Tuttle then has a stolen by Malco. Malco shot of the buzzer on the way. It's good! And after three, Rochester by 5 and 38-33. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
After 64 years serving this community, B&B Menswear of Rochester is closing their doors. Now is the time to save on all men's apparel as they liquidate their inventory. Take advantage of their store-wide savings on slacks, shirts, shoes, and more. Stop in today to see Phil, John, or Margaret as the B&B store clears its inventory of their name brand menswear. B&B store is going out of business and passing the savings on to you. Stop by today and save. Buying your first home? Let the experts at First Federal Savings Bank help you through the process. At First Federal, all of their mortgage loans are serviced locally, with payment options that are convenient for you. Their staff will work with you, answering your questions and providing professional service. First Federal will even pay standard closing costs for qualifying first-time home buyers. Just another way First Federal takes care of you, your local mortgage lender.
Fourth and final quarter we go. The Rochester Lady Zebras now lead by 5.
Yeah, they scored 18 points in that third quarter. Outscored the Lady Lancers 18-4. Lady Zebras had 20 at halftime. They scored 18 in the third quarter. And they lead now 38-33. And it's going to be another tough-paced fourth quarter for
right.
Lady Zebras.
Lady Zebras will start with the basketball. Holland works to the right side after a double pick. Behind the arc, right wing, sends left side to Ruff. Ruff fake, right, jumps down low to Abbott. Her layup on the way is no good, but a foul coming on LaVille, and Abbott will go back to the line to shoot two. Great look by the freshman, Morgan Ruff.
Abbott's been struggling underneath all night long. She's had her opportunities at the free throw line.
Bailey Abbott back at the line to shoot two for Rochester, who are leading 38-33 with 7:47 to play in the basketball game. Thomas on David Musselman. It hasn't been pretty, but it's a lead.
Yeah.
First one for the senior. Short. We'll have one more. I think Coach Stasiak went to the bench once in this half, and that's for Morgan Ruff. That's been it. Second one for the senior. Good this time. 39-33. Rochester's biggest lead of the night is at 6. Here comes a little half-court trap coming. Freshman Ashton Brenner crosses the timeline right against Holland. Here comes the run and jump. Ball is loose, picked up by Sadock, and she is fouled by Morgan Ruff. And the good news is Rochester will shoot free throws from here on out.
All right, Ruff will pick up her first.
She'll be out of bounds to LaVille on the far side. Ashton Brenner will trigger it in. Does so to Lead. Lead's jumper on the way. No good. Stasiak rips the board and gives out to Ruff, who gives him Malco. Becky runs it before. Hesitates, crosses the timeline, now works to the right side. Malco works it left. In the paint. Down low to Abbott. And we're going to have a foul before Abbott's shot. But Abbott's shot went in that time. And it's going to send Malco to play for one of the bonus. Poor girl, she can't win.
The foul cock per second. Yeah, the one she makes doesn't count.
Abby Malco the line for one and the bonus.
Malco with 15 points in this ball game.
First on the way for the junior is good. Looking to push this lead to 8 with the next freebie.
That one, she gets her average.
Becky with one more. Ace will come back in after this made free throw. It's good. So Ace back into the game and coming out of the clock. 7:23 to play in the game. Rochester by 8 and 41-33. And they'll stay in that half-court kind of trap, run and jump defense.
It's been working this half.
Ace with the basketball. Stop at the timeline, switches directions, now leaps ahead to Tuttle, and it's knocked out of bounds. Going to say last touch by Tuttle, to Rochester, going to get it back. Great job by Stasiak.
Yeah, great job by Keith Stasiak, jumping into the passing lane, getting up with her hands on it to create the mishap by Tuttle.
Ruff drives it right, digs it out to Malco. Malco holds high on the right side, 7 minutes to play in the game, bounce pass to Holland. Holland drives it right behind the arc, hesitates, works right side. Down low to Stasiak, deep in the lane, goes up for the shot, a lot of contact, she found the shot, through the line to shoot two.
It's all right,
Tim! The Tuttle, yep, the Tuttle picked up first, second. Keith Stasiak to the line to shoot two, so Lady Sabres looking to push his lead to 10. Junior eyes it, flies it, yeah, is it rattled in, is it good? Back into the game is Vernon. Coming out is Tuttle for LaVille. Brad Thomas by David Musselman.
So Rochester looking to go up by 10 when they trailed at 9 by halftime.
Yeah. And as big as, what, 12 or 13
in the
second quarter.
They trailed by as many as 12 in the second quarter.
Morgan Ruff comes out. Allie Larkin back in. 6:55 to play in the game. Rochester by 9. Keaton Stasiak with one more for the Lady Zebras. Looking to push this one to double digits for the first time tonight for Rochester. Stasiak second on the way. It's good again. 43-33. Rochester by 10 with 6:50 to play in the game. He's quickly up the floor, hesitates, accelerates, and Keith Stasiak's going to be called on the reach-in. That'll be number 4. So who's he going to go back to here? Ruff or Musselman? I'd go back to Ruff for sure.
They're going to call out on Holland. Well, that's not what he said. He said 10, which is Holland. Well, I don't know. Didn't he?
Oh, then the bounce pass is failed by Stasiak. Stasiak, middle of the floor, stop, up, right step, and we're going to have a charge on Stasiak at number 5. And Morgan Ruff will come back in. Great idea, she just can't float.
Zebra follow on 12, Stasiak, the 5th.
See, now Coach Stasiak is going to argue that last foul. They motioned that it was on number 10, which was Holland. So, but now they're going
to. So Stasiak was done.
She's got to finish with 10 points.
Rochester by 10. And now he's got to work with a short bench. Morgan Ruff back in, Rochester in a zone. Each gets the ball, tipped away and stolen. Ruff has it, leads ahead, and she has it stolen by Lead. Lead of the basketball for LaVille. Rochester by 10. Asher Brenner drives the baseline, goes to the basket hard, skip pass to Each. Ace in the lane is going to be fouled before the shot by Larkin. Wow, Rochester's going to pull that thing out here and run some clock. That's Larkin's third. Now both teams will shoot free throws from here on out. That's Aaron. Aaron Ace at the line to shoot one of the bonus for LaVille. Rochester up by 10. Ace's first free throw, high arcing shot, no good. Rebound by LaVille. The putback by Lead is good. And now LaVille will use a timeout. It's a 60. You're listening to Lady Deer Basketball, 92.1 WROI. 6:22 to play in the basketball game. Rochester's lead is 8 at 43-35. Keaton Stasiak has fouled out. And
Larkin has 3, Abbott 2, Holland with 2.
Out for the lane, rises up, shot possible. The window's good, and we're back up by 10. 6:10 to play in the ball game. We're pressing the well. And Vernon, unforced turnover there, travels. Rochester going to get it back. And now will you see Rochester maybe pull it out with some clock here?
Yeah, they need to, absolutely. The Lady Lancers are got foul problems of their own. Tuttle and Lead both with 2, Zeiger and Esch with 3, Vernon with 4.
And Vernon just fouled out. Is that what you said, Vernon with 4?
Yeah.
She just fouled out. And Morgan Ruff will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus. 5:57 to play in the game. Rochester by 10, and Tuttle coming back into the game for LaVille. Morgan Ruff in the line for one of the bonus, with Rochester up by double digits with 5:57 to play in the game.
Lady Zebras have outscored the Lady Lancers 25-6 in the second half.
Ruff free throw, no good. Abbott with the rebound. Now Ruff kicks it out to Malco, who holds the volleyball line in front of the Rochester bench. Holds. Now the count starts. Drives it left, in the paint, outside to Holland. Next, dribbles left, inside the three-point line, out to Malco near the timeline.
And they come out and get
you. Rochester's going to run some clock.
Try and get to the free throw line.
Malco runs against double team, out to Holland. Next, back to Malco near the timeline. Malco, a couple of dribbles near the center circle against the double team.
I'll tell you what, Lee over her.
Wild,
yeah, right over.
Good call. That's awful.
Yep, Stasiak doing everything you can to keep from getting the technical.
And now Malco drives. She fouls through the line to shoot 2 shots. Who's that foul going to be again?
Should be Lead, but we'll see who they put it on. Nope, they're going to give it to Ace. That's her 4th.
5:17 to play in the game. Rochester by 10. And Becky Malco will go to the line to shoot 2 for the Lady Zebras.
Malco has 19 points in the ballgame tonight. Looking to add to that.
Becky eyes the first one. Lets it fly. Good.
I think that's Rochester's biggest lead of the game.
Oh, absolutely. 11. One more coming from Malco. Becky eyes the second one. Lets it fly. And it's good again. And now we're going to have a foul on Lead. A hard block out, knocks Malco to the floor. Lead picks up the foul. Malco will go back to the line to shoot 2.
That's Lead 3rd. That's just a stupid foul there. There's shooting the free throw, and she made it.
So Malco back on the line to shoot 2 more. Not even sure a second came off the clock. Rochester by 12 at 47-35. Still a ton of time left.
You can block the shooter out. You just can't knock her down.
Malco's free throw. Nope. Too hard. We'll have one more. They're still talking to Lead.
Yeah. Well, people in the crowd yelling that, you know, all she did was block her out. Well, that's true, but you can't do so in such a manner that you knock her to the floor.
You can defy LaVille.
Yeah.
Rochester's
right
hand.
Yeah. So. That's just good. LaVille ball.
Now, the official just said you got to wait to go to the line. In the lane before, until the ball hits the rim. That's last year's rule. That is not this year's rule. They charged that. They changed that.
The free throw, I still don't understand how is the free throw good then.
Because it was fulfilled penalty, and if Becky would have missed it,
then she'd have got the shot over the
shot.
So why bother calling it? Because it's their ball anyway. She made the point.
I don't know. 13-point lead for Rochester. Heesh. Out of control. Oh, it's going to be fouled by Ruff. Good Lord. These guys, especially this guy right here.
Yeah.
He is out of it.
He's reading this year's rule book. So Ruff picks up her 2nd.
So it'll be interesting to see what he calls here, since you can go into the lane once the shot is released, not when the ball hits the rim. Each at the line for 1 and the bonus. First on the way for the freshman, good. She'll have one more. Well, everybody did what they needed to do.
Everybody was in the lane before the ball hit the rim.
48-36, Rochester by 12, 5:16 to play in the basketball game. Team Stasiak and the Lady Beavers were fouled out. Second one for Eish. No good. Rebound to Holland. Next, ahead to Malco. Malco crosses the timeline. Works to the right side against Rochester, or in front of the Rochester bench. Out to Holland. Next holds between the rings. No pressure yet. Now back it out. Holland against Lead. Works to the left wing. Kicks it out to Malco. Malco near the timeline against Eish. There's the count that started. Up pressure being applied. Out to Holland. Heck, holds near the timeline, near the sideline. Works to the middle of the floor. Hesitates, now accelerates. Gives him the quarter to run. Morgan kicks it out to Malco with 4:39 to play in the game. Rochester by 12. Malco picks up a dribble. Out to Holland. Holland back to Malco.
Eish with four guarding Malco. Lead with three.
And then Malco throws it out of bounds. A lot of contact, no foul. It's going to go back to LaVille with 4:23 to play in the game. Rochester by 12.
Lady Zebras 8 of 11 from the free throw line in this fourth quarter. That's all but two of their points.
Eats gets it ahead to Zeiger. Zeiger at the top of the defensive tunnel. Go back to Eats high on the left side. One dribble back to the tunnel in the corner. She'll fire a three. It's good. Timeout LaVille. 4 minutes to play in the game. It's 48-39 Rochester. You're listening to Ladies Here Basketball, 92.1 WROI. To play in the game. Rochester leads 48-39. Biggest lead of the game for LaVille has been 12. The biggest lead for Rochester has been 12.
Yep. Rochester trailed by 9 at halftime. Came back and took as much as a 12-point lead here in the second half.
LaVille has one timeout left. Rochester with 4. Team Stasiak is done for the night. She fouled out earlier in this quarter. And Rochester will have the basketball. Malco will bring it up. Boy, I tell you what, Lead is in the side of the Jersey Holland. Made a man defense by LaVille. Malco around the defense, in the paint. Kicks it out to Abbott, who gives to Holland. Holland against Lead.
Malco should have the green light because Eish has got 4 fouls.
Absolutely.
She can't really, I mean, the last drive Malco took, Eish just kind of let her go. She can't do much to stop her.
Malco, crossover dribble, works in the lane. In the corner to Ruff. Ruff then travels. Out of control. She's going to float just a little bit with 3.5 to play in the game. Rochester up by 9 at 48-39.
I think she wanted to try and throw it across court to Abbott. Lady Lancers jumped that passing route. She had to change her mind at mid-strike and ended up traveling.
Zeiger to lead, top of the key. Zeiger between the make that lead between the rings. Eschenbrenner at the elbow to Zeiger. Ball loose. Ruff picks it up. Now Mealy has it. Now Malco. Back for the basketball. 3:15 to play in the game, up by 9. Now this is the center circle. Around Eish in the paint. Kicks it outside to Holland. Holland at the free throw line. Now to Larkin at the volleyball line. Rochester just looking to run some clock here. Back down to the 10-second line. Larkin works the left side. Now bounce pass to Malco. Malco stands at the volleyball line, high on the left side. Drives it right, and then we're going to have a foul on Eish, and that'll be number 5 on Eish, and Malco will go back to the line to shoot 2.
Well, Malco is 5 of 6 from the free throw line this quarter alone.
So she's going back with 2.
7 of 8 in the ballgame.
Looking to push this lead back to double digits. As Coach McCullough is going to have to go back to his bench. As the clock rolls, yeah, 30 seconds, a minute.
30 seconds, I believe.
And coming into the game is Zadak. And Eish is done. But anytime you got Leeds still on the floor.
Yeah, and she's hamstrung a little bit with three fouls.
Yeah.
So
2:53 to play in the game. Rochester by 9. Now it goes the line to shoot 2. So Becky Mouth with the line to shoot 2. The Lady Zebras up by 9. Mass confusion over here at the scores table. Person for the junior on the way. No good off the side of the iron. We'll have one more looking to push this lead back to 10. Rochester by 9. 2:53 to play in the game. Becky, 3 dribbles. Eyes the second one. Lets it fly. No good again. And Paley Abbott just picked up another foul. And we're going to walk to the other end, and Tiger's going to shoot free throws. 2:52 to play in the game. With these two freebies, LaVille has an opportunity to cut this thing to 7. So Lucy Zeiger at the line to shoot one of the bonus, the 5'10 junior for LaVille. Sets herself for the first one. Lets it fly, and it's good. So LaVille has 2 young ladies foul out. Rochester with 1. One more coming for Zeiger.
Rochester lit the pace up in the third quarter. But here in the fourth quarter, it's kind of become stall ball.
Second one good again for LaVille. Now LaVille in the full court press.
Zebras just struggling to try and hang on until the end of the clock.
Holland with the basketball. Brings it up the floor for Rochester. Gets the lead. Across the timeline, right to the center circle. Works to the left side. Kicks it out to Malco. High on the left side for Rochester. 2:38 to play in the game. And now we're going to have a foul on Tuttle. And Malco's going to go back to the line to shoot 2. Well, she missed 2 just moments ago. Becky Malco back in the line to shoot 2. Looking to push this lead back to 9 with 2 freebies here.
5 of 8 in this quarter.
First one's good for the juniors. We'll have one more. Coach Stasiak not even looking to the bench. He shouldn't. Back one for Malco. No good. Rebound fought for, and Rochester comes out of there with it. Becky has it now with 2 to have to play in the game. 8-point lead for the Lady Zebras.
That Abbott has kept it alive.
Yep,
Malco was able to come up with a loose ball.
Larkin works to the top of the key against the freshman. Eschenbrenner, now back to Malco, right in front of the Rochester bench. Couple of dribbles towards the middle of the floor, and now Holland has it. Holland, right elbow in the corner to Larkin. Larkin, now back to X. X back to Larkin, down low to Abbott. And LaVille knocked it out of bounds. With 2:08 to play in the game, Rochester by 8. It'll be out of bounds, baseline right for the Lady Zebras, as Holland will look to trigger it in. And the bounce pass is kicked away by Lead. Rochester will try it again. 2:08 play in the basketball game. Rochester by 8. And now Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. Playing the game. Bailey Abbott gets the inbound pass from Holland. Rochester the basketball. 2 minutes to play in the game. Up by 8. Malco around the defense. Pass her up. Rough in the paint. Outside to Larkin. High on the right side. Right in front of the Rochester bench. Larkin a couple of dribbles to the right. Now switches direction. Comes back to the left over the floor. Bounce pass to X. Holland against Lead. A minute 45 to play in the game. Rochester at 49-41. Holland in the center circle. Drives it left. Stops. Outside to Larkin. She dribbles away from her defender. Middle of the floor now for Rochester. Works it right. Larkin, jump pass outside to Malco. 90 seconds to play in the game. Malco middle of the floor. Works high on the left side. Rochester by 8. Minute 26 to play in the game. Crossover dribble. Down the middle of the lane. Right hand to lamp on the way. No good, but a foul on Tuttle as Malco hits the deck hard. As Tuttle undercut her. And Becky going to go to the line to shoot two. She's slow to get up. So right on her tailbone. Becky had a wide open layup. Tuttle undercut her. And Becky still grimacing a little bit. Now smiling a little. So going to the line to shoot two. Malco ready. Eyes the first one, lets it fly. It is good as it rolls over in front of the iron. Rochester by 9, 50-41. It was 1:23 to play in the game.
That's a 24th point for Malco.
Second for Beck. Good again. 51-41. Rochester by 10 with a minute 20 to play. Lead quickly up the floor behind the arc. Left side to Ashenbrenner. Ashenbrenner a couple of dribbles. Outside to Sadak. Now to Lead. Lead goes to the basket hard. She's fouling the shot. Fouling the floor, maybe?
Yeah, on the floor.
She'll go to the line to shoot two as Larkin's going to pick up the foul. With a minute 9 to play in the game, Rochester by 10. Lead at the line to shoot two for LaVille.
Lead had 11 in the first half. She's only got 2 here in the second half.
Is that 4 on Larkin? First one by Lead is good. 8 points.
They called it on Malco.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Okay. One more coming for Lead. Set the Rochester lead to 8. She does so. Full court press by LaVille. Holland gets it in with a minute 8. Rochester up by 8 with a minute 3 to play in the game. Right to the center circle is Holland. Holland takes her defender all the way to the free throw line. Now back to back out with 57. Now back to the timeline with 56. Right to left. Out to Holland with 53. Holland against Tuttle. There's a mismatch right around the defense. Stop. She's fouled. And Malco will go back to the line to shoot two. As that's either going to be on Zeiger or Tuttle. It will be on Tuttle.
That's 5 on her.
And coming back into the game is Neely Cox, the 5'11 freshman. And so that's 3 of the 3 starters for LaVille fouled out. And Malco will go back to the line for 2 with 48.3 to play in the game. Rochester up by 8. Junior's first one on the way. It rolls around and rolls around. Yep. Rochester now by 9, 48.3 to play. And don't forget, tomorrow night we're back at home. They've got another game against the Conicwall. Second one, good. Nice soft touch, gets that one to roll.
And a 14 for Malco from the free throw line in the fourth quarter alone.
10-point lead. Now Becky Malco going to pick up a foul.
Sure.
Has lead flop.
What was that?
How does that happen? Lee didn't even have the basketball, and she wasn't even close to the ball.
I don't know what they called.
The lead will go to the line to shoot two with 45 seconds to play in the game with Rochester up by 10. Lead eyes the first one, lets it fly, and it's good. One more coming for the senior. Three on Becky.
Yes.
Okay. One more coming for Lead. Looking for Lead to 8. Lead second one. Good again. LaVille will use their last timeout as the 60. You're listening to Ladies Eater Basketball at 92.1 WROI. 5 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by 8. Rochester will have the basketball underneath LaVille's basket. They need to go the length of the floor against the full court press. Malcolm will look to get it in.
Yeah, he's not the ball yet. Larkin.
Larkin will look to get it in. Now things move. Larkin, bounce pass into Holland. Holland ahead to Bailey Abbott, who stops and gives back to, boy, LaVille missed a great opportunity to foul Bailey Abbott there.
You're right, yeah.
Abbott an opportunity to give it back to X with 30 against lead. X dribbles left. Now pass outside to Malco with 25. Rochester by 8. Malco around the defense. Outside to Larkin now with 20.
And I would think if LaVille wanted the foul, they'd be fouling anybody that touched the ball except Malco.
Holland has it with 15. Holland holds, now dribbles with 10. Rochester with by 8 with 9 seconds to play in the game. Holland drives it left with 6. Outside to Ruff, now to Larkin with 2, and that's going to do it. Rochester's going to beat LaVille on the road, 53-45. You're listening to Lady Hear Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
First Federal Savings Bank is Rochester's only locally owned bank. Stop in today to start a new checking or savings account. Learn more about our online banking options or sign up for Go Green Checking, the checking account that pays you back every time you use your card. Stop in today to see why local banking is better banking. First Federal Savings Bank, serving Rochester and surrounding communities since 1966. At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
I've been buying vehicles at Shepherd Chevrolet for over 16 years. They've always had the vehicle I wanted at a price that I could afford. I trust Shepherd's sales staff to give me the best price and the best financing available. From my work trucks to my personal vehicle, Shepherd's is the only choice for me. Stop out to Shepherd Chevrolet today to get your next vehicle. They really are my local hometown Chevy dealer.